I'm at the Eaton Rapids Museum. They allowed me to film this. For whoever wants to see the Museum of Eaton Rapids on YouTube, this would be it. Pretty good.
Well, the one time we step outside the back door a minute.
That's okay. I never. Let's see. I like this. Wow, a lot of metals. Let's see. What is this?
All right, I'm gonna take off.
Yeah, this is very nice.
Which would fit for the Grand Army of the
Republic
Post. Exactly. Grand Army of the Republic's a veterans organization for Union Civil War veterans.
Cool.
Much like the VFW and the American Legion today, in fact, they're the forerunner and help those organizations get started.
Yep, ready. No, just talk what you just was telling me.
We're in the James Brainerd Post number 111 building in Eaton Rapids, Michigan, of the Grand Army of the Republic. The Grand Army of the Republic is the veterans organization of Union Civil War veterans founded in 1866 in Illinois by Dr. Benjamin Stevenson. It grew to a nationwide organization of over 400,000 members. Almost every small, large community had a post. Of veterans who would gather together weekly, bi-weekly, monthly for fraternity, charity, to assist the orphans and the widows, and those who could no longer work, the disabled, and loyalty to the flag. The Brainerd Post met here. James Brainerd was an officer in the 6th Michigan Infantry, died during the war in New Orleans. After the war, they named the post here for them. The building was built by the veterans. They actually met on the second floor, which you'll see in a minute. The first floor they rented out to various businesses to help defray the cost of the building and provide a little income to the post. There were over 400 men at one time or another over the course of the history of this post that were members here in Eaton Rapids. They also met as a county battalion. The 11 posts located in Eaton County would gather together once a year for a week-long encampment at various places around the county. The last 20 years, the Eaton County Battalion met right here in Eaton Rapids over in Island Park, which is actually the GAR Island Park, the name for that. The Grand Army of the Republic helped the VFW and the American Legion get started, and they met together for years because the Grand Army made a decision not to allow other veterans into the organization, but it was strictly for Civil War veterans, guaranteeing their own demise. So the museum here is dedicated to their memory, and the five allied orders of the Grand Army of the Republic, the Sons of Union Veterans, was founded in 1881, became the official heir of the Grand Army, charged with carrying on their memory. The Women's Relief Corps, auxiliary to the Grand Army of the Republic, an organization that still exists today, was the official auxiliary of the Grand Army. We also have the Ladies of the Grand Army of the Republic, the Daughters of Union Veterans of the Civil War, and then the Sons has an auxiliary. And those five organizations together make up the Allied Orders, the Grand Army of the Republic, and they're all still in existence in today. Four of the five are very active in Michigan. The Ladies of the Grand Army of the Republic no longer is. So we have displays for each of those organizations. Also, we're currently featuring the reunions in Gettysburg in 1913 and 1938 on the 50th and 75th anniversary reunions to commemorate that battle. So we have a mannequin out front in a Grand Army uniform with a authentically costumed Boy Scout mannequin from the 1930s. We have a picture presentation in PowerPoint format also of those reunions. And then around the hall, we have various uniforms, equipment, badges, memorabilia. Every time they got together, it seemed like they made a commemorative badge or commemorative ribbon of some type. And so we have an interesting collection of those. Upstairs, the meeting room is actually set up as a post-meeting room with the commander station and the chair set up, an altar, the various stations for the senior vice commander, the junior vice commander. And so we'll take upstairs and then you can take a look at that.
Okay, let's go. Now.
The Women's Relief Corps met in this area. The Corps number 38 met in conjunction with Post 111. The ladies would meet in this area. The wallpaper, we were able to find examples of the original wallpaper that were in here. This is very close to the pattern that they had.
Oh.
So we have some memorabilia.
And the lightings are the same? Or?
The lights are not original.
Okay.
They are modern lights, but they are what would have, the type of lighting that would have been in here.
Okay, it looks nice. Now, the main room. Ow.
This is the main room. We're going to actually help their meeting.
Damn.
Chairs lined up on the side, the altar in the center, covered with an American flag and the Bible on top.
Cool.
The meetings, the Bible will be opened ritually by the chaplain.
That is neat.
The Bible dates to a Grand Army of the Republic member out of Sunfield. That belonged to Samuel W. Grinnell.
This is very nice. I like it.
Sat up on the stage in the center chair, the what we would call secretary and treasurer would sit up with here, the quartermaster, and then the other chairs are ritually posted. There's always a vacant chair with a hat sometimes placed in it to remember those who had passed on.
Oh, that's kind of nice.
No longer with the...
Would it be this chair right here? Or?
This chair right behind
you. Oh, that one. Okay. That is kind of nice. Ah.
The picture behind the commander station is James Brainerd, the namesake of this. And you can always find a picture of George Washington and Abraham Lincoln.
Yeah.
Also.
And the music playing, would they be listening to something like that, or?
It is of the period.
Huh.
It is of the period. Either
kinda
Civil
nice.
War, Civil War music, which they did sing a lot, or post-Civil War music that they would have used. They have an interesting set of prints right here. The podium, easel podium here, print. This was intended to be a monument in Washington, D.C., and men came around to the communities and would sell these posters to members of the Grand Army of the Republic. You could have the center engraved with your own service record or as a memorial to a killed, a deceased member. We got two of these. These were scams. The men never intended to build the monument.
Okay.
Pocketed a lot of money.
Oh.
But they're very common around the country. But they would have hung pictures on the wall. They would have had memorabilia. A lot of organizations would do memorial scrolls of members that were all in the company. This particular portrait right here, our collection, is past department commanders here in Michigan.
Oh.
Men who commanded at the state level. Two of them went on to be commanders in chief of the organization, Russ Elger and Washington Guard.
Ooh, the flag. That looks nice.
During the return the flag ceremony on the 150th anniversary of where the regiments returned the battle flags to the state of Michigan, we presented a flag like that to the state. On the second floor of the rotunda in the state capitol building in downtown Lansing, they have a collection of various veterans organization flags. And they did not have a Grand Army of the flag.
Hmm.
They do now.
Yep, exactly.
The headquarters of the Grand Army of the Republic at the state level was in the state capitol building for many, 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 many years.
Hmm.